What's up, guys? My name is Ryan, and we're fucking the lothric twins today. Full disclaimer at the start of this video, I'm summoning someone because I'm at the wit's end trying to fight this fucking guy as a caster. The targeting is shit. The guy fucking shoots spells at you and then teleports behind you. I can't do it. I could probably do it if I spent another 100 hours just learning exactly what I'm meant to be doing. But this is meant to be an easy sorcerer guide, and there's nothing easy about this boss or the way this boss works. So I'm summoning someone. As soon as you summon someone, it becomes incredibly easy. That is my tip to you for beating this boss as a sorcerer. You just summon someone and you shoot the shit out of spells. The games become unfun. To that extent. And I think it part of it's due to the fact that the camera and the lock-on system's a little bit shitty with this boss because he's teleporting around. I don't know what it is. I think with a melee build, it would probably be a lot easier. But we're just going to summon someone. You should always be able to summon an NPC, even if you're playing offline. It shouldn't be an issue. But basically, we're summoning someone, and we're going to do this boss. As soon as you summon someone, though, this boss is so easy. This is actually the second time I'm trying to record this, because I wasted a humanity, basically, before. I went into the boss room, and the guy couldn't follow me. One of the biggest bugs in this game is phantoms can't follow you into the boss room. It really, really, really annoys me. We're going to cast Hidden Body. Okay, shut up. We're going to cast Hidden Body and then go into the boss room. And it'll give us a free hit on him. As long as our phantom doesn't... Oh. Basically, that usually gives you a free hit on the boss. But yeah. And now we just sit back and we relax. And we just cast some spells at him. Now, I'm using Crystal Soul Spear. So I'm really hoping we don't completely run out of mana. Oh! Which could very well happen because he's fucking teleporting all over the place. Oh, that is such bullshit. That is complete bullshit. He fucking hid behind the pole to do that spell. No, you're full of shit, you little piece of shit. This is the easy fight. I can do this part very easily as a sorcerer. It's this part that becomes difficult. He puts these things up in the air and then he teleports behind you. Oh my god. There's no chance. And then as soon as someone else is attacking him though, it becomes incredibly easy. Now, I've been told that you can target two separate people. I want to make this very clear in this video. Right now, I'm trying to move the target. There is but one target. You have to kill the little guy to kill the big guy. You can't target the little guy. You can only target the big guy. So even if I wanted to do this as a sorcerer, I'd have to wait for him to be behind. You can't do it. The good thing about Crystal Soul Spear, though, is you can use it and it will penetrate, so it will hit him if you go from the front. But my god. Oh! Fuck off. I got my shield up there in time, luckily. Okay, let's just use this to heal. This fight is so easy though, just shooting spells if someone else is distracting them. And he's dead. No? Oh, that guy's dead. This guy somehow has health, and now he's dead. See you later, mate. Yeah, it's really disappointing that I had to do that. It's such an easy fight when you summon someone. But for melee, I'm sure it's easy for a sorcerer doing that on my own. I'm sorry, but I can't do it. I'm not good enough. And I don't expect like most people to be good enough as well. So I'm really fearful as to how I'm going to do the rest of the game as a sorcerer, because it's really hard. It's really incredibly hard because you just don't have enough time to get your spells out. I guess before we finish the video, I do want to cover my stats. I'd leveled up a considerable amount to try and get this guy down. Even with 20 vigor, with some of those attacks that he was doing, he was still one-shotting me. I suppose if I was a melee character, I'd have more armor, but I had 20 vigor, 24 attunement, so I could get 4 spells, 17 endurance, 10 vitality, 14 strength, 31 dexterity, 50 intelligence, 7 faith, and 12 luck. I got my katana. I've been using the court sorcerer's staff plus 9 because I've worked out that's the best scaling one. The dragon crest shield plus 4 I was using because it's got a very high fire resistance for this guy, and I found that was important. The dancer's crown, it's light, had a little bit more armor. Archdeacon's holy garb, some acquainted gloves, and some desert trousers. I had the bellowing dragon crest ring, the hunter's ring for some more dexterity, the young dragon's ring for more sorceries, and the milk ring for more dexterity and to hopefully dodge more of his attacks. This was just a disappointing fight. I'm gonna do a strength playthrough, I've decided, and I'm gonna upload it just completely on the channel, because I think this game's going to be so much easier with the strength playthrough. It's just been a shit fight as a sorcerer. Half the time, you're either having to resort to melee anyway. I probably could have beaten that boss if I had resorted to melee, but it wouldn't have been easy, and this is meant to be an easy sorcerer guide. And so the easy thing to do there, and as you saw, like, literally the guy barely even tried to attack me. And even the Sunbro, like, he probably didn't have a hard time. It's just working with both at the same time, dodging and attacking, that just becomes so hard. Make sure you, when you summon someone, you pick someone that looks from their armor very melee-centric. And then from there, like, Crystal Soul Spear is doing 700 damage to him each one that hit. Like, it's amazing. I mean, I could have done that for a bunch of other bosses throughout the game, but I feel like the risk reward just wasn't there. Whereas this guy, like, literally, like, I was playing through the game. This is a playthrough for me, and like, I wasn't enjoying it every time I went and fought that guy. And I think what it was is you died at what I would assume to be something cheap. Like, if you shoot spells in the air one way and then teleports behind me and kills me while I'm hiding behind a pole, or if he teleports and he teleports behind a pole so I can't see where he went, but he uses his charge up, like, magic attack that's very hard to avoid, where he shoots a pillar down on the ground and then I die, that's frustrating. If he teleports behind me and the camera glitches out and I turn around and he hits me in the back and I die, that's frustrating. And I think that's part of this boss is, when you're a melee, the teleporting is less of a problem because he'll probably do it less because you're not out of range. But when you're a caster, he's just doing stupid shit like that all the time. And when you have to have the added frustration of the other guy casting spells at you, or the fact that even if you're trying to attack the small caster guy on his back and none of your attacks are hitting, it just becomes too frustrating. And I guess that's probably half the reason. I think it's definitely hard. The easier way is to summon someone, but also it gets rid of a lot of those frustrations. And what made, I guess, it even more frustrating is I could go in and I could get summoned by White Soapstone and just the boss was a piece of cake. And as soon as you try and go in there and you try and do it solo, there's just too much shit happening. It's too kind of cheap and glitchy. And it just started making me really mad. So I summoned the guy half for my sake for this one, I think, so I can get through and keep playing this fucking game, and just not be mad, because I was getting mad and you don't want to be mad. Anyway, that was a little bit of a rant and a little bit of a guide. Not really a guide. I mean, all I was doing was shooting spells at a guy that wasn't targeting me. But that's the tip for that. Fucking just summon someone, because as a sorcerer, this boss is hard. Tell me how to beat this guy as a sorcerer, guys, and I'll come through, I'll play the game again, and I'll do it. Maybe they'll patch it and make it a little bit more consistent. I don't know. But Jesus Christ, this boss made me so fucking mad. Woo! All right, see you guys.